Hey guys, welcome to my new video. I hope you all are doing well. So before starting this video, let's do a quick recap what we did in our last video. So in last video we saw that how do we create an EC2 instance, a fresh one, using Linux, and then how do we use an SSH client or any terminal window to connect to our EC2 instance. So in this video, we'll look into what is S3, how do we connect our S3 bucket to our EC2 instance, and other forms of it. So let's start the video. So before directly starting with the implementation, let's just understand that what actually is S3. So Amazon S3, or simple storage service, it provides the object storage which is built for storing and recovering any amount of information or data from anywhere over the internet. So the storage is not a limit when you are using S3. It's highly scalable. That means you can store n amount of data and n type of data on the S3 storage. So usually when we deal with large files, on a local system, the speed is an issue, and sometimes if a certain file system fails, we are not able to retrieve the progress and we again have to start from the scratch. So this kind of issues are not present inside the S3 when you're using S3. That's why it's highly scalable and most used data management tool by the organizations or even for an individual purpose. So certain things that you have to keep in mind while using S3. One is the buckets. So buckets is nothing but it's a terminology used for a container where you will be storing all the data, and here the data is termed as objects. So when you are working with S3, all the entities or all the data types or the files you will be storing inside the S3, it will be termed as objects. Then with every object, there are some keys associated with it, an ID to each object, we can say. And another thing is that region. So the bucket is always associated with the region, which will be which we will see in a short while. So this is basically the overview of the S3. Now let's just directly jump onto our session. So in our last video, we saw that how to create an EC2 instance. So this is a landing page, the dashboard page for the instance. I've already created and made this instance running. Now we have to access the S3 page. So making the use of the stop search bar, let's just go to the S3 console. So, okay. So this is a console for the S3. So there is already a bucket available, but we are not going to use this bucket. We'll be creating our own. So creating a bucket is very easy. So all you have to do is you have to hit this button, create bucket, and it will take you to another page where you have to give a unique meaningful name to it, otherwise it will always throw you an error. So for this tutorial, we can say sample AWS sample S3 AWS bucket for the make it unique. Then you don't really have to change here, and we'll just uncheck this option. And if you don't want to uncheck this option, it's okay. This is for the public access, so I haven't tried. This was like purposefully unchecked in my previous bucket, so we'll do this experiment too. So for now, we'll leave it as it is, and rest you don't have to change much in this, and hit create bucket. Okay, so it says successfully created bucket. So now instead of one, we have two buckets here. So this is a process, how do you create a bucket. Now what we'll do is now we have our bucket in place. So in order to search or create any file or access this bucket in an EC2, so we have to provide an access to the EC2, because these two are different services. These are not connected to each other. So in order to connect this, we have to provide a bridge. So that bridge is a set of roles. It's like a manager which gives you an access to your S3 from your EC2 instance. So we just talk about that there is a bridge or a manager which is responsible for giving you the access of the S3 to your EC2 instance. So it's known as IAM. So IAM is nothing but Identify and Access Management. So this is another service which helps us to give the permission or to manage all the resources available on the AWS. So this is a very important service, and if there is any of the issue with your service, then you always have to assign some roles or change, look out for some permissions, which you can do using this IAM. So in order to do this, we have to set a role. So to create a role, we'll go back to our EC2 instance, and I'll give you the overview of the process of how do you create a role, and there we will give the access of the S3 to our EC2 instance. So going back to our EC2 instance, we'll just open this in a new tab. Okay. So we have our instances running. So in order to supply a role, what you have to do is you have to mark your instance, whichever is running, and you have to okay, so before that you actually have to create a role. So I already had a role, so I was explaining that. So in order to create a role, what you have to do is you have to search IAM here and open this in a new tab. And here you have to search for roles tab, which will be present on the left hand side of the window. On clicking role, it will give you, so this is a role which I created earlier, so it will ask you to create a role. So when you'll click on create a role, it will give you a list of service for which service you want to create a role. R is on the very top, EC2, we'll select the service and we'll hit next permissions. Here we'll search for S3. And roles related to S3 will come, and we have to select this Amazon S3 full access. On clicking this, just hit the next tag, and here you have to give a key and a value. So key is very simple, you can simply write EC2 and EC2 S3, and value you can give it as EC2 S3 full access, and hit next. Now you have to provide a role name, so EC2 S3 full access DD. So we'll just, you can give any meaningful name, even S3 full access would work. So that's it. So this will create a role in the management. Yeah, so you see EC2 S3 full access DD. So we have created our role. So once this is done, you have to go back to your EC2 instance, and here you have to select your instance, go to the actions, and then you have to select the security, and you have to select modify IAM role. So coming here, so if you are doing this for the first time, this will be null and there will be no role assigned to it. It will be looking as like this if you have no IAM role assigned. So what you have to do is you have to click on this drop down menu, and you will be getting a list of all the roles that you have assigned to it, and there will be a role here which says S3 full access. So just to avoid the conflict, you can select this and you can hit save, but I've already created one, and just for the easiness of this purpose, I'll be selecting this one only, and I'll just cancel the process, and you just have to hit the save button and you will be redirected back to the instance page. So this means that your role setting has been defined. Now our next part is, how do we access this? So let's just directly jump onto our terminal and access our S3 bucket. So yeah, open the terminal. So in our last video, we had discussed that you have to provide the PEM key and the address. So I'll again recall that, click your instance, hit connect and copy this one. So you have to make sure that you are accessing this terminal from the same folder where your PEM key is located. Click it, and it will ask for the some missions, and yeah. So we are here inside our folder. So now for this, what I have to do is, in order to check that whether you have got access to your S3 bucket or not, there is a simple command called AWS S3 LS. So when you'll write this command AWS S3 LS, you will be getting a list of all the buckets which you have created, and this means that your AWS S3 connection has successfully created. Now we'll do some of the operations quickly. Now this was the major part of the video, so what we'll be continuing next are the some of the minor operations of copying the file or uploading the file back to the S3. So I already have some of the files here, so what I'll do is I'll just upload this file to S3, then I'll get the same file from S3 and change the name of it and store it on a EC2 instance. For that the command is AWS S3 CP, and first, if you want to send a file from your EC2 instance to a S3 bucket, then you have to provide the file name before. So here our file would be sample text and sample.txt, and then you have to provide the path of the S3 bucket. For that you have to give your S3 bucket. So this is a tag to access the S3 bucket. Just name this either AWS S3 and here, and just give it a meaningful name, that sample from EC2.txt, and when you'll hit enter, so it says upload done. So we'll go back to our S3 management console and open this file, and here it is. So it was completely empty, and we just transferred a file from a local EC2 instance to this. And when we open this file, you will see that this is a key. A key is simply a name or an ID associated with it, and we get all the status of this object. So this is every file is state as an object here, and when it was created, which region it is created, who is the owner, and everything you will be getting here. Now we have seen that how you send your file from EC2 to your S3, but what if your all the files and logs will be usually kept on the S3 bucket to access those? So for that, there is again a simple command, just a switch of words. So it will be AWS S3 CP. First, you have to give the path of your bucket where the file is present, S3. And this is the name of the file and space, or what name you want to store in it. So sample from S3.txt. So it says download. So now when you hit LS, so here you will be seeing an extra file which says sample. So when you'll G8 is not present, nano sample from txt. So this is a sample text file, so which we created in our last previous video. This is the same file which we are exchanging the data between EC2 and S3. So that's it. Hope you like the video, hope you understand the topics, and hope you enjoyed and also got the taste of some of the other services of the AWS. So quick summary, S3, it's a simple storage service provided by Amazon on the cloud service, which is highly extensible, scalable, and provides an extra layer of security. And IAM, which says identify and access management, which enables you to access and manage access to all the AWS services. And that's it. If you have any questions, you can just feel free to pop them in the comment section below. And if you really like the video, just hit the like button, share, and subscribe with your friends. And thank you.